All right, so getting to the halfway point of this album, we go into track number four, which is entitled He's So Dull. And I'll just jump in real quick, because to me, if there's ever a track that is a candidate for the worst terrible 80s TV theme music, this one's it. Much more so than Wet Dream and Drive Me Wild, because those had a little bit of kind of funkiness to them. This one,
I just hope Dez doesn't listen to this show.
Why? Did he write this? Did he? Or did he produce it?
Written and produced by Dez Dickerson.
Well, all I can say is what I just did, and that's about it.
Hi, Dez.
But I will say
that... Don't you like our podcast?
The one thing that this song proved, though, was that it showed that Prince could do this type of music. He could write a run-of-the-mill, and even though he didn't write it, he could play it, he could put it under his name, under the Vanity 6 label in this case, but he could put this sort of run-of-the-mill type rock and roll with the best of them. And really, at the end of the day, it is another relatively short track. It's a bit of a ditty. And there's not that, pretty much, there's not that much more to say about it. It's very childish. That's the other note that I had in, or the other remark I had in my notes. Just kind of the other songs, of at least Wet Dream is a little bit playful. Nasty Girl is very playful. But this one is pretty much filler to me. It's like, I'll leave it there. Captain, what are your thoughts on this?
This is another great pop track.
I knew it.
And it makes me, knowing that Dez wrote it and this is his song, impresses me, you know, for him as a songwriter. Because before, I just thought it was another Prince song. And I'm like, for Prince, you know, it's not that great. It's still a good pop track. But then, you know, I'm reading this stuff. I was like, written and produced by Dez Dickerson. And I'm like, damn, Dez, yeah, that's a good song. But I love the little organ in the background of this. You got the big hand claps that come up every now and then. And I think someone's already mentioned this. I think it was Toe Jam at the start. And I always laugh at this lyric. He doesn't even wear blue jeans. And it always reminds me of Prince's comments about blue jeans. But this was featured in National Lampoon's Vacation, and that's probably where most people heard it from, because I'd never heard it anywhere else. Great pop song, big hooky chorus. It's good. It's a good one. And this one had an extended version as well. The album version's 2.5 minutes, extended version just over 4 minutes. That might have been what MC was thinking before.
Yeah, I got my songs confused, yeah.
The extended version, it doesn't sound like it was then edited down for the album version. It really sounds like the album version was taken and then expanded on to make a longer version. So, he's come back to this track like he did with the other one, what Drove Me Wild, and then played around with it again. But yeah, so I think there's a lot of filler on the extended version, but I do like it. It's got a longer section. It's got a solo bass line, which is pretty cool. And that fills out like the middle part of this track. And yeah, you've got Dez Dickerson on drums and guitar, and written and produced by Dez. So good job. Yay.
All right. Player, what are your thoughts on He's So Dull?
Yeah, it's a cool song and it's catchy, but to me, it doesn't fit musically in the rest of the album. Like, I think, you know, you've got like these other kind of pre-1999 space boogie kind of futuristic-y kind of tracks like Nasty Girl and all that. And then you got this, which is kind of like a throwback to more sort of the early 80s Prince, like Dirty Mind kind of sound. It's like borderline on that kind of era. The song reminds me of those early 80s bands like B-52s and the Go-Go's that channel that kind of like a 50s doo-wop sound style and cheesy keyboards and stuff, Devo, that sort of stuff. And yeah, like Captain said, it was in Vacation Movie. Nasty Girl was in Beverly Hills Cop. So yeah, like they were really pushing these into like movies, into mainstream kind of things. Again, it's a short, it's only 2 minutes, 2.5 minutes. It just doesn't kind of fit for me. It seems like Dez wrote it maybe around that Dirty Mind era. I was kind of laying around and then, oh, we need a track to fill in the album. Oh yeah, we've got that one kind of thing. Because yeah, it just, the instrumentation doesn't sort of match up with the rest of the album. My eyes, so. But yeah, it's a cool song, but it's real throwback for me.
Again, Prince was he was stretching it pretty thin when he's grabbing songs from Dez to fill out the album. But just one thing you said, player, about pushing these songs into movies. It's funny that he did that with these side projects, but he didn't really do it with his own music. And apart from these early years, he never really did it again.
Yeah,
that I can think
true,
of.
Yeah.
I mean, there's a few random things like. Like what he didn't he put like 319 in Showgirls or something and then you got Girl
yeah,
Six
Song of the Heart
all Prince music
and all that. Yeah.
But you know generally he never really went back to putting songs out for movies. It's interesting. Maybe he got burnt like financially and he's like, nah, I'm not doing this anymore.
I don't know. Like, Vacation was a Warner Brothers movie, so maybe Warner Brothers thought, look through their roster. Yep, let's get this song, throw it in there. You know, who knows? But, you know, maybe it was just a crossover thing to promote their artists. Who knows? But
oh, yeah, possibly. Yeah. But still, he would have had to give permission for that, you'd think. Who knows?
Yeah.
Yeah, this was also very early in his career, so could have wanted to get exposure, you know, put my music out as in as many different or through different media to try and get exposure. Right. The other thing is that a lot of his early 80s to mid 80s music was used in movies, I think, because it was hit music. They were like, these songs were hitting the charts, either in pole position or in the top 10, most of them. And I think this was another example. I mean, this song wasn't, but, you know, a pop hit, but his music tended to be around this time. So it's like, what's that other movie? Risky Business. It's got DMSR in it. DMSR. So, you know, I don't know whether he really wanted that to be in the movie or whether or not it was just he was gaining steam on the, as a pop artist, getting a bit more exposure and he was probably more well known. So don't know. Interesting.
Like I got the impression that maybe Nasty Girl and all that blew up in the clubs, but maybe not got a lot of radio play. So maybe like to get more exposure, they put the songs into movies and stuff to push it a bit more. I don't know.
Yeah. Well, one way or another, he was out there in many different forms and the variety of artists that he was producing and writing material for. This was like starting to peak in the music on the music scene. Toe Jam,
I haven't got much more to say. It's a bit more rock than some of the other songs. That's obviously the Dez influence. Again, it's kind of got a bit of a country thing going as well. Country rock, synth pop. The bass actually moves quite a bit in the chorus. Which is kind of cool. It is very, very TV show though, isn't it? I could really imagine that line being played for like 20 seconds. And then the next thing you know, someone walks through a door, like the house door or something. It's like, you can imagine the sitcom.
Because that's how every 80s sitcom starts. Someone walks through a door.
Like, you imagine this 80s sitcom about Vanity, you know, this sex goddess living with this nerdy white guy kind of thing. And it's like, that's the premise of the show. Like, you know, The Odd Couple or something.
I want to watch that show. Oh, I really want to watch that show.
It's got synth bells again. Is that sort of cutesy girl thing? Just like all the songs on this album, it's really aimed at that sort of high school age. Like, it's really aimed at like sort of 16-year-olds, this whole album, boys and girls, I think. That's, you know, the whole theme of, you know, oh, he's so dull and, you know, he's reading science magazines and sometimes I think it's talking about me. Yeah, I don't have much more to say about it. It's all right. I mean, I appreciate it for what it is as a well-crafted 80s pop song, but I don't really ever feel, oh, I need to go back and listen to that song. So
there's a fair bit of album tracks that we've spoken about, really, right? I mean, the huge hit single leads this album off, and then the next two or three songs sounds like we're all in agreement that they are not filler. I wouldn't go that far, but just album songs, yeah?
Yeah.
No, I don't know.
Except for Captain. Captain's in love with the...
Pop. Super pop.
Super pop, in a way.